I still ask myself what happened. I replay it over and over again in my head, as if that could make any difference.
Sometimes, at the end of a long day, I look around and ask myself, how did we get here? And then, like a hot knife in my side, the memory of it all comes flooding back.
I remember there was evening, and there was morning, each one sweeter than before. At night it was dark, but dark like chocolate, or E minor, or obsidian. Every morning we awoke to a holiday, and the world rose to greet us with laughter, like the host of a great hall.
Abundance and satisfaction were all we ever knew. But we didn't know how good those things were because we never knew lack or disharmony.
How could we be surprised by satisfaction when disappointment wasn't in the vocabulary of our experience?
And yet, somehow, every day, we found something new and still yet more wonderful to behold. There was no such thing as faith, for we could see all things, and what we saw held us in thrall. There was no such thing as hope, because nothing ever went wrong, and there wasn't something better to hope for.
You could say we were rich, but there was no money. No currency but love. No spectrum of wealth except that someone who had been in the beginning was the peak and the fountainhead, and without him was not anything made that was made. And that was all we needed to know.
Well, almost all we needed to know.
I wish I could say it was a villain that burst through the wall screaming at us in blood and treachery, but it was quieter than that.
I wish I could say it was a dragon dragged us helpless to our death. But it was something far more sinister and simple.
Who was it murdered our happiness? What hail did fall and dam our orchard blossoms in their infancy?
How grew up weeds in the fertile garden of our hearts to choke the fruits and bounty of perfection?
We were princes in our first estate, and who would make us rogues and peasant slaves but our own wayward desire? I blamed her, and she blamed the deceiver, and in the end, there was no one left to blame.
All our days now have become shadows.
Some say the first death was Abel, his blood crying out from the ground, the first murdered son, the first buried child. But it's not true. The first death was our innocence. No one buried us alive. No. We dug our own grave.
Thank you.